tapos lang dito sa AP.
Okay, good morning once again. And before we proceed with our lesson proper, may I request Lee Van to please lead our opening prayer. Lee Van. Bueno, si Lee Van. Angeline, ikaw na lang.
Ako? Wait lang. Okay, let's pray. Lord God, our precious God, our Heavenly Father, thank you for this day that you have given unto us. May you guide us and bless us sa sweet akong lesson. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
Amen. Okay, before we start, let us have first a meditation for our Bible verse for this week. Taken from the book of Psalm chapter 1 verse 6. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. So please listen carefully and feel the presence of our Almighty God by this meditation.
Greetings in the wonderful name of our great God and Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. This is Temple Christian Academy's verse for the week. It is found in the book of Psalms, 1st chapter, verse 6. Psalm 1:6. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked shall perish. How does God know the way of the righteous? It is because it is under and in conformity with His will. It pleases Him, and therefore it brings blessings in every step. Unlike the way of the wicked, which is evil in his sight, it will never receive blessings. To God be the glory. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word. We pray, dear Father, that you guide us all along the way. To you alone be all the glory. All this we ask and pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, your only begotten Son. Amen.
Okay, once again, good morning, and let's going to discuss different laws of exponents, particularly ang lima ka laws of exponents. So, who can give me one law of exponent?
Product of power.
Next.
Power of power.
Next.
Power of a product.
Next.
Power of a quotient.
Next, number five.
Quotient of powers.
And ang next, ang pinaka-powerful power. Tagaan ko pa na. Price ang makaguess ang pinaka-powerful nga power.
Power product.
Luko.
Power of product.
Sala.
Power leader. Power leader.
Quotient of power.
Kili-kili power. Joke lang.
Super. Superman.
Okay, next. Let's go in to discuss first product of a power. So it is stated there that for any number x and positive integers m and n, so it is represented by x to the power of m times x to the power of n. As you can see, class, parehas ang aton base. Ano diri aton base? Anong base na ako? X. Ang base, amo na siya ang sa dalom, ang sa babaw, amo ng exponent. So, kung parihos ang aton nga base, kag-multiplication ng aton operation, ang ginahimo naton is gina-add lang ang exponent. Diba? Amo na siya usually ang aton ginahimo? Okay, copy the common base, then add the exponent. So, consider the following examples. Example number one, 2 cube times 2 to the power of 5. Kung ato na siya klase expand, both silingon sang 2 cube is 2 times 2 times 2. Diba? And 2 to the 5th power, kung i-expand, that is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Or, applying the product of a power, copy ang common nga base, which is? Bilang base? 2. Then, add the exponent nga 3 plus 5, that is?
8.
8. That is why we have 2 to the 8th power. Claro?
Oo!
Berto, x to the 4th times x cubed. Manualbe.
X7
okay,
to the
x
power
to
of
the 7 power.
X to the power of 7.
Okay, number 3, 8x cubed times 3x squared. Ang himuon nyo din class, i-multiply nyo lang niya ang 8 times 3.
Ay, ang 8.
8 times 3, pila?
24.
Okay, 24. 24. Then copy ang common nga x. Then i-add ang exponent. 3 plus 2.
5.
So may aras kita, 24x to the 5th power.
To the power.
Clear?
24x, sir.
24x to the 5th power.
To the 5th power.
Or to the power of 5 or raised to 5. Next, number 4. M times exponent, yeah, a plus b times m to the power of a plus b. So what is our base?
M.
M. Then you add tayo ng exponent. A plus a.
2a.
M.
Okay, 2a. Then,
plus
B plus B.
B plus B, 2B.
Okay, 2B. Amo na siya nga copy. Ang common nga base nga M raised to the power of 2A plus 2B ang aton answer.
2B.
Clear?
Okay.
Clear.
Yes, sir.
Clear.
Okay, next proceed. Sa, anong ikaduwa gani? Power of? A power. Okay. To raise a power to another power, so sa nakita na ninyo nga may power na may power, pagyad, multiply the exponents in symbols. So as you can see, we have the base x with the exponent m with exponent n. So ang imo undere, i-multiply lang ang duwa ka exponents. Amo na nga may ara kita x raised to m times n. So consider the following example number 1. 5 to the power of 4 to the power of 3. So anong himuon?
3 times 3 times 4.
Okay, multiply lang ang 4 times 3 then i-copy lang ang base nga 5. So 4 times 3?
12.
12. So that is why we have 5 to the power of 12.
To the power of 12.
X, x cubed squared. So multiply ang exponent. Bilang exponents.
6 over 6.
So we have 6 to the 6th power. I x to the 6th power. Next. M to the power
to the
of 3b squared
three.
Equals. So copy ang base nga M.
M to the power of 6b.
Times 3b times 2.
M to the power of
6b.
Okay.
M to the power of 6b.
So nandiyan si power of a power.
Oh,
oh. Power.
Next
letter C. Power of a product. Kaginayang una-una, product of a power. Tapos
product
power of a power.
Power.
Subong naman niya, power of a product.
Power of a product.
Power of Naruto.
Do pa rin use lang sir, sa ano sir? Sa isa? Sa power
same
of power?
Siya, galing kay Direya, usually, ang ginagamit sa power of a product, duha ka base or duha ka variable. Okay, buta, save lang na sila gapong process. Okay, ma-proceed na lang ta sa another. Power of a quotient. Okay, di rin naman sa power, magkasabad, manis yung pasayod, pasayod. Okay, sa power of a quotient, bukod si Lingon, division na niya or fraction. So, for a power of a quotient, both numerator and denominator are raised to the indicated power such that x over y to the power of m is equal to x to the m over y to the m. But si Lingon siniklas ang exponent, raise mana siya si x kay m, kag si y may exponent muna siya nga m. But si Lingon sinisang fraction class, naka-raise na sila sa exponent nga m nga duwa. Claro?
Oo, sir.
I wait lang.
Yes, sir.
Next. Dapat si y should not be equal to 0. Ang atong bala exponent, ay ang atong denominator, dapat hindi mag-equal sa 0. Kaya kung mag-0 na siya, ma-undefined na na. Example, x over y to the fourth power equal na siya sa x to the fourth power over y to the fourth power. Klaro lang?
Tugin distribute yun lang sir sa dalom sa baba.
Kung ano ang power ni numerator, amo man ang power ni denominator. Pero isa-isa okay. Gitna. The same there sa number 2. 3x over 2y squared. But silingon sina 3 squared x squared over 2 squared y squared. Ang exponent na niya is distribute gitna siya sa kada isa ka term. So i-simplify nimo, 3 squared pila?
9.
Amo ni nga nag 9. Then copy si x squared. Then 2 squared?
4.
Then copy si y squared sa denominator. Then amo na yung final answer. Klaro lang?
Oo.
Yes, sir. So let's proceed to another. We have 2a squared b over 3cd cube. So distribute isa-isa sa kada term ang aton exponent nga 3. Mahimo na siya 2 cube. Then a, di ba squared ang power sang a. Si times mo na siya sa 3 kay power pa power na siya. 2 times 3
6.
Amo na nga nag a to the 6 kita.
Okay.
Then ang b raise sa cube. Same sa dalom, 3 cube c cube d cube. Klaro?
Oo.
Simplify, 2 cube. 2 times 2 times 2. 8. Then copy si a to the 6th power kag si b cube. Next ang sa dalom. 3 cube or 3 times 3 times 3.
27.
Then copy si c cube then d cube. Gets?
Oo.
Okay, for the quotient of powers, wait lang. Isang ko ba na kay kasabat yung sa dalom. Quotient of powers.
Quotient of powers.
May ano sa babaw?
Kaya lang yan eh. Black eye. Stop share ko sa danay.
Gawin mo na sir.
Napot sa guro. Wait lang. Mara, sige po ng pistil.
Design.
Why sa gagawa na ay?
Wala, sir.
Blanco.
The green.
Tara na. Basta ako, shut up powers. So, let's proceed. Okay, sa quotient of powers, when dividing powers with the base, exponents are subtracted. Dito ka ginaya sa power of powers, di ba gina-add na to? Dire naman niya sa divide kita powers, gina-subtract naton ang aton yung exponent. So example, the same lang ni sila ha, the same lang ni. So x to the m over x to the n, that is x to the power of m minus n. Dapat si m greater than siya sa kay n para hindi mag-negative. Tapos ang base naton nga x should not be zero. Amo niya usually ang aton ginagamit. Pero pwede man na siya ma-express into fraction form like this. Pero equal lang na siya. Amo niya siya ang gamiton kung ang aton nga m is less than kay N. Ang sa babaw ya, amo ni siya ang gamiton naton kung ang M greater than kay N. Sindihan?
Oo.
Okay. Take note class, any number raised to the power of zero, pila ganang answer?
Zero.
One. Maski million pa na da, basta iya exponent zero, that is always equal to one. Tandaan ha?
Okay.
Kung ang M greater than sa N, amuning gamiton ang sa babaw. Kung ang M less than sa N, amuning sa ikaduwa.
Okay.
Kung ang M equal sila ni N, amuning gamiton ang ikatatlo.
Okay. Oo.
Okay. Atagan tayo example.
Basta hindi lang mag-zero si X. Oh,
basta ang base natin nga X hindi mag-equal sa zero. Example.
Okay.
We have 2 to the 6th over 2 to the 4th. So that is, copy lang ang common nga base which is 2, then 6 minus 4. Since ang M naton is greater than sa aton N, that is why gamiton ta 2 raised to M minus N. Klaro?
Okay.
So that is why we have 2 raised to X minus 4. And that is 2 squared. Clear?
Clear.
Kaya gingamit naton, M is greater than to N. That is why amuning gamiton. Ang ikaduwa naman, si M less than kay N. So ang gamiton ta, itong ikaduwa. Klaro?
Okay.
Sir, given na yung 1 sa fraction. Oo. Given ang 1.
Given na.
Okay.
Ang formula naton, ito ang base raised to M minus N. Ang denominator. So we have 2
one.
Raised to 6 minus 4. Pila na siya kung i-simplify?
2 squared.
Okay, 2 squared. So pila aton nga answer?
1 2 squared.
1 over 2 squared.
Or 1 over?
2 squared.
Kung i-simplify gani, pila?
Ay.
1 over?
4.
4.
Four.
Or 1 over 4. Klaro?
Oo.
Okay.
Next, number 3. Since hindi pareho sa aton base, X kag Y ang aton ng mga variables, so pila?
Ipabayaan lang.
Wala na natin i-simplify. Kag hindi na natin gamitan sa loss of exponent since lain-lain ang aton nga base or variables. Pero?
Hindi na siya pag-simplify.
Amuna na siya ang simplified form. Clear?
Clear!
Okay. Okay. Try to screenshot na yung activity kaya hatagan ko another.
Abaw.
Try to screenshot na yung activity that is page 155 sa inyo libro. Medyo damo-damo na siya pero hapos lang na. Ala, hapos ha. Hapos na bala. Example, oh. X to the 7 times X to 9.
Ganyan.
Okay.
Ganun
siya.
Okay.
Share ko na so, rin. Sana all the
next. Aria, ang another.
Laman.
Ay, dahil lang kayo. Gagawa.
Gagawa.
Kalma, kalma.
Okay.
Sino kina-excited daw?
Sino sila naman mo niya chikan, sir?
Sa kwan eh, next. Kung matapos mo, okay. Pwede man sa 3, iupod mo.
Okay.
Kung matapos mo, ikaw ng huwaran eh.
Oh, grabe ba. Huwaran sa ano?
Huwaran, ano, huwaran estudyante. Huwaran. Rebulto doon sa tubang ka, tempolo.
Ay,
okay. Ka again ah, sa amon niya klaso, ang sa babaw, ginatawag exponent. Ang sabadalom, ginatawag na siya nga base.
Ang sulong base.
Si base, amo na siya ang term or variable which is being raised upon or ang ginabutangan exponent. Next, ang exponent naman, ginatawag mo na siya nga power or sa babaw sang base. So we have exponential form. So the exponent of a power indicates how many times the base multiply itself. But silingon sang exponent ng ginabutang or ang power, ga-indicate na siya kung kapila ka beses i-multiply ang base sa iya kaugalingon. Klaro?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, okay, example, x to the power of n, buo silingon sina x times x times x, depende kung pila ang n hasta. So example, 5 cubed, that is 5 times 5 times 5. Gets na? Na. 3 squared, pila na?
3 times 3.
That is 9. How about negative 3 squared? Take note how many parentheses na.
Nine.
So that is negative 3 times negative 3 equals 9. Basta may parentheses class, buot silingon, ang negative, i-multiply mo man siya by itself, that is negative times negative, amo na nga nag-positive. Ari siya class, oh, negative 3 squared, wala parentheses. Basta wala siyang parentheses class, ang imo dira nga i-multiply itself, ang 3 only. That is 3 times 3, pila?
6. Ay, 9.
9.
Then, copy ang sign nga negative.
Okay.
Claro?
Claro.
Amo na siyang kinalain sa may parenthesis kag wala parenthesis.
Okay.
Next, any number raised to the first power is? Ano be?
Exponent.
Any number? Kung nang i-exponent 1, ano ang answer?
First ang Japon.
Victor.
Iyag yapong kagalingon eh.
Ha?
Three kaya ang iyang exponent 1. Example, 3. To the power of 1. Subot silingon 3. 87 to the power of 1, 87. But silingon, any number raised to the first power is itself. So, we have multiplicative law of exponent. Anong gina-state ang multiplicative law?
If the bases are the same, and if the operations between the bases is multiplication, then the result is the base powered by the sum of individual
exponents. Okay, ang ito siya kagina ang product of a power. At ang una kagina, gina-copy ang base, tapos gina-add ang exponent. Example, x to the m times x to the n, that is equal to x raised to m plus n. So take note kay sa exam, it is either amo niyang ibutang ko sa choices, multiplicative law of exponent, or ato ang sa una naton nga duwa. Nga sa una nga gin-discuss ta. Example, 2 cubed times 2 to the 4th power, pila?
2 to the power of 7.
2 to the power of 7. So kung ipal expand mo, amo na siya ang duwa. Yeah. Next. Product rule. The same na siya kagina. Saying goes, base, base, add. Anong but silingon? If the bases are same, add the powers. Then copy lang ang base nga parehos. So 2 to the 4 times 2 to the 5th power?
2 to the power of 9.
Okay, 2 to the power of 9. Or simplify naton pila siya
512.
Next, pow product of a power. So pila na siya kung simplify?
Negative 81.
Balik to kinder.
512.
So to the power of 81.
9 times 2.
Pasyabu ka naman. Next. Division law of exponent. Anong gina-state ya, Tom?
Ay, sir.
Read.
If the bases are the same and if the operations between the bases is division, then the result is the base powered by the difference of individual exponents.
Okay, the same to siya kagina, atong naka-fraction. Gina-subtract naton ang iya exponent, gina-copy ang common nga base. Example, x to the power of m over x to the power of n, that is x to the m minus n. Ato na siya, kagina, ato walang tatlo. Atong greater than ang m, amuning gamiton. Kung less than ang m sa n, ato naman ang 1 over atong kagina. So, quotient power property, amuto siyang kagina, una-una. When dividing an expression with a power, subtract the powers, they must have the same base in order to subtract. Dapat parehas ang base, ha? Hindi ka pwede ka-subtract sa power kung ang base ni mo, different. Applicable lang na siyang subtraction of powers when the base are the same. Clear?
Clear. Sir, ask ko na si Sigfred kung ang 5 of ang exponent niya 0. Anong answer? Di ba wala?
1.
So, wala
exponent. Any number raised to the power of 0 that is always equal to 1.
Iski!
Maski pila pa na kamilyon, maski pila pa na kamilyon, basta yung exponent 0, that is 1.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, pila na siya. Mental. X to the power of 8 over x cubed.
5. 24. Ay, ano
ni? Anong answer?
Ano ni?
X to the power of 5.
X to the power of 5.
X to the power of 5. X to the power of 5.
Para, yeah.
X to the power of 5.
So, pag ikadua, 1 over...
Hindi ito yung walk kalom. 1 over... X.
So,
if n
x to the power of
5.
The same lang yapon. 1 over mo lang. Next.
Wow.
Exponential law of exponents. If the exponential form Steven, is powered by another exponent, then the result is the base powered by the product of individual exponent. The same to kagina. Kung ang power may power pagid, i-multiply mo lang ang duha ka power, then copy ang base. So, the same na kagina. So, ara, B, pila. Ara, o. Kasi, guys.
3 to the power of
6. 3
to the power of 6. The power of or, pila na siya? 3 to the power of 6.
Wait. Ala ko, 37.
Pila. 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3.
729.
Okay, pila? 729. How about this one? 2 to the power of?
2 to the power of 6.
Pila?
6.
4.
4.
Next product of exponent, hampal diri. If the product of the bases is powered by the same exponent, then the result is multiplication of individual factors of the product, each powered by the given exponent. So, ara siya klaso, di ba, dua ang aton diring terms, x kag y. The same to mula kagina nga, i-distribute muna kada exponent sa kada term.
Oo.
Okay, example. Ara class, may muna siya.
3, 4,
3 to the 4th, x to the 4th. So, simplify, pila na siya? 3 to the 4th?
Wait.
3 times 3, 21.
3? 7,
14, 21.
27. Pila? 81. Okay, 81, x to the 4th power. Amo na siya lang ang answer. Next. Ang quotient, atong kagina, itong gindistribute ang kada? Kada ano gani?
Kada exponent.
Sa kada term. Then, i-perform ato ang, itong tatlo gula kagina, ato ang m equals n, m is greater than n, m is less than n. Okay. Ara sa kagina. Okay, sa negative power property class, take note, kung negative ang exponent, both silingon sina class, 1 over a cubed na siya. Kung negative yung exponent, ibutang mo siya sa denominator or sa dalom. Intindihan?
Kung negative siya sir, sa dalom siya ibutang?
Oo.
Sa exponent lang?
Oo. Example, okay. Are na siya class ang zero law of exponents. Any base powered by zero is equal to?
1.
Okay, any number, bisan ano pa na da? Example, 3 to the power of 0, 1 na siya. O, tanan na, biski ano ka damo na?
1.
1 na gyapon.
1.
Rule, a to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Okay, hindi na niya siya pagdalon.
Hey.
Amo tayo activity niyo. Hindi lang na ya.
Okay, sir.
Okay, ma-stop share ko
lang, sir, muna.
proceed to another.
Sir, radical na ba, sir?
Labilog lesson, no? Tatlo.
Bo, ano mag-uwan? Kapasang aton nga classmate.
Roots and radicals.
Ha, hindi ko din mag-atag activity sa roots and radicals, pero i-include ko lang sa exam.
Okay.
Okay.
So, dapat mamati igid. Pero hapos lang niya.
No.
Sana siya kung kapalo ka. Okay, roots and radicals. Okay, there is a roots and radicals. Anong tawag sa radicals? Kisa?
Roots.
Roots.
Roots. They are directly related to exponents. So the simplest types of radicals are particularly ano?
Square roots and cube roots.
Square roots and cube roots. Okay. Radicals beyond square roots and cube roots exist, but we will not discuss them as in-depth. Mag-focus kita sa mga basic. So the symbol used to indicate a root is the radical symbol. Amo na siya class ang kinatawag na radical symbol. Amo na siyang radical symbol, ha? Okay. Every radical expression has three parts. Ano ang iyang tatlo ka parts?
Radical symbol.
Amo na siyang radical symbol.
Radical. Next.
Index.
Ang index, ano da? There is an example, the ending index.
49.
Balda. Balik grade 1.
Oh.
Para ang 2, amo na index. And 49, inatawag nga?
Radical.
Radical. Nagsindihan? Tatlo parts ang aton nga radical expression. Ang sign, ginatawag radical. Ang sagwa, index. Ang sasulod, radikan. The index of a radical is a whole number greater than or equal to 2. Hindi pwede nga kung ano siya, ha? Decimal or fraction. Dapat whole number ang index. So the index of a square root is always 2. Ang index of nakita nyo usually class, ginahambal natin square root of 4. Wala na nadaginabutang class ang 2, kaya understood na siya class nga ang index ng square root is always 2. By convention, an index of 2 is not written since it is the smallest possible index. Why na siya ginabutang ang 2? So the square root of 49 could be written as, amo na siya class, ibutang mo ang 2 nga index or square root of 49 na lang kaya wala na ginabutang ang 2 nga index. Klaro? Pero bisan diin at diduwa sa ila, the same lang na ang value. So all indices greater than 2 must be written. Pero kung 3 pababaw na class, ibutang mo gid ang index. So ano na siyang indices? Plural na siya sa index, ha? Basi mag-likuan ka mo. So the index of cube root is always 3. Kaya ang cube, pila gani?
3.
Cube root of 64 is written as, amo na sa class. Ang 64 is our radicand. 3 is our, ano nang 3 na ton?
Index.
Index. Index. And we have the radical symbol. So, amo na siya magsulat ka, cube root of 64. Or kung basahin mo siya, cube root of 64. What does square root mean? Anong ba silingos ang square root? The square root of a number is another number which when multiplied by itself gives back the original number. But silingon, for example, anong square root ni 4? Anong square root ni 4?
2.
Okay, kung i-multiply mo siya by itself, mabalik siya sa original number. So 2 times 2?
4.
Okay, yan kung anong ginatawag ng square root.
Oo.
Kasi ako ni-multiply mo siya by itself, mabalik siya sa original number. Next, what does the cube root mean naman? It is the same. Another number nga kung i-multiply mo by itself 3 times, kaginaya sa squared 2 times lang.
Oo.
Cube root, since ang index is 3, so i-multiply mo siya by itself 3 times, mabalik siya sa original number. Example, ano ang cube root ni 8?
Cube root ni 8?
2. Yeah. So, i-multiply mo siya 3 ka beses. 2 times 2?
6.
2 times 2, 6.
4!
4 times 2? 8! So, nakita ninyo, ang cube root, kung i-multiply mo siya 3 kabeses, mabalik siya sa original number. Okay. Clear?
Yes, clear. Sir.
Example ng square root. Square root ni 49.
7.
So, 7 times 7.
7.
49. Original. Next.
49.
Again ha, tandaan. Dito sa aton nga, ng extracting square root, di ba sa aton itong facto nga quadratic equations? Di ba? Ang aton nga square root, pila gani iya value? Diba? 2, positive kag negative. Okay, this is the same. Positive 7 kag negative 7. Again, ang positive class nga value sa pagkuwato sa square root, binatawag na siya yung principal square root. Diba usually ginapangayo ko lang sa inyo ang positive. Kaya ang 7, which is positive, amo na siya ang kinakinahanglan kag ginatawag nga principal square root. Negative 7 is called the negative square root. Pero usually, ang ginakwa lang naton ang positive square root or ang principal square root. Examples ng cube root. Cube root of 64, that is 4. Because 4 times 4, mabalik siya sa original number, which is 64. Next. Another niyang answer is negative 4. So negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4, that is negative 64. What are the first 10 whole numbers that are perfect square? First 10 whole numbers.
4.
4.
4.
Ah, wait. 10. Ay, hindi.
Oh, hindi perfect square ang 10.
16.
16.
16.
25. 25. 25. 5 times 5.
8.
9, sir.
36.
Okay,
9.
Oh, now 2 times 2, that is 4. 3 times 3, that is 9. 4 times 4, 16. 5 times 5, 25. Next.
36.
36.
36. Next.
81.
49. 49. 49. 7 times
7. 49.
Next.
64. 64.
64. That is 8 times 8. 81.
81.
That is 9 times 9.
100.
100. That is 10 times 10. And?
121.
121. That is 11 times 11. So we have... What are the first 10 whole numbers that are perfect cube?
Ah.
2 times 2 times 2, that is 8.
8.
3 times 3 times 3. 27. 4 times 4 times 4.
64.
5 times 5 times 5.
125.
125. 6 times 6 times 6. Ara na ah, ilibog na kaulo niya. 216, 343, that is 7 times 7 times 7. 512 is 8 times 8 times 8. 729, that is 9 times 9 times 9. And 1000, that is 10 times 10 times 10. Clara?
Oo.
If a number is a perfect square, butsilingon, kung perfect square, makuhaan mo sa exact square root. Pero kung hindi sa perfect square, gina-estimate lang na siya naton. Example, 16, that is 4 squared. Or the square root of 16, that is equal to 4, since 16 is perfect square. 25, the same. Square root of 25, that is 5. How about ang 1.44? That is
1.12.
Estimate lang naton. 1.44, hindi kayo 144. Next, 9 over 121, pareho sila perfect square. Pilang square root ni 9?
3.
Square root ni 121?
11.
Okay, amuna siya nga nag 3 over 11. Amuna siya ang principal square root. Next, 36b squared, So pila ang square root ni 36?
6.
Okay, 6.
6 times 6.
Square root ni B squared?
36.
B squared.
B. Amo na siyang 6B na lang ang iya nga square root. Next. M to the power of 6. I-apply lang kani mo ang ato ang power of a power. So that is?
M6.
Ibang square root niya ang iya sininga index pila gani?
2.
Butiling on 6 divided by 2?
3.
Okay, amo rin nga nag-M cube bilin.
Okay.
Next. Sa perfect cube naman. 64, that is 4 times 4 times 4. So the cube root of 64 is 4. How about 125? Pila iya cube root?
5 times 5 times 5.
That is 5. And 1.728?
1.2 times
1. Estimation lang ni sa iya class sa calculator. Kaya hindi siya perfect cube. How about 216? Pila niya ang cube root ya? 36. Ang 125, pila yung cube root?
5.
5. That is why 6 over 5. And, pilang cube root ni 8?
2.
Ang cube root ni C?
3.
3.
Cube root ni C? 3.
C.
C. C. Dawa mo na nga anak to. C. Kaya 3 divided by 3. 1. Klaro? Cube root ni 8 is 2. Next. 6 divided by 3 nga index?
6.
Wow, 6 man kuno.
Ay, ito gali ito.
Okay, 2. That is why m squared bilin. Klaro? And this one. Ilang cube root ni 27?
3. Negative 3.
Negative 27 yung cube root is negative 3. Then, 12 divided by 3 ng index?
4.
Amo ni nga anak 4 ang bilin sa exponent. Klaro?
Gambal ko.
Klaro?
Oo.
Not all numbers or expressions have an exact square root. Aha, atong kagina or cube root. Ginahatagan lang na sila naton sang estimation or gina-approximate lang naton. So, if a number is not a perfect square, kung silingon, hindi mo na siya makuhaan square root. Exact ya. Yeah. The same na siya kung hindi perfect cube, hindi mo man makuhaan exact cube root. So, you can approximate lang ang inang mga square root kag cube root gamit ang calculator. So, example, square root of 40, since hindi siya perfect square, i-approximation is 6.325. Square root of 135, approximation niya is 11.619. The same na sa cube root of 40, is 3.42, and cube root of 74, that is approximation is 4.198. So, amula na siya ang sa roots and radical. So, I will not give activity for this, but study lang, kay upod ko na siya sa final exam. Klaro?
Okay.
Yes.
Right. So, wala na pa
December 16, 17, final exam.
Okay.
Okay, please.
Okay, please.
Chatanay ulit, so wala naka picture. Kagina. Okay, a study na siya klasa. A study. 155 to 158.
Ay, hindi na.
Okay na, tapos na. Nakasensyon na.
Yes!
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So, may questions pa, wala na.
Wala na.
Okay, pasahay sa ano
na. Wala na activity sa ligan.
Activity sa Friday, so paliog aga lang. Kaya kung napon, di ko na naman chikan.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Nakapabakuna na tanan?
Oh, sabuli.